Hello, my name is Mordred, and I'd like to welcome you to episode 33 of this Let's Play Prophesy of Pendor 3.7063. In the last episode, we did in fact join the Fyrdsvane as a mercenary. Just before we did that, they made peace with Ravenstern, so that idea is kind of moot, where we're planning to cut Ravenstern down to size and then basically establish a kingdom over there when we could. However, they are now at war with the Dashar. So for this fight, I think we will mostly just be doing it for the gold and the glory. We do still need to improve our prestige. If I press the right button, it's now 202, so we've gained 100. We still need to get it to around 600, which is where we left off previously, and increase our honour. And the honour, I think, is already higher than it was, simply because... Where is it? No, it can't be. Nah. Previous honour is kind of buried in my notes, I can't be bothered to look for them. Right, so we did fight a series of battles here around Sangsafid, which we did win, but we are rather low on manpower at this point, so we are going to go and try and restore some troops. The marshal is no longer telling us to follow him around, so we won't do that. We may run some quests and stuff instead. Aiden Redsword was defeated. Oh, that was probably the massive battle that was going on down there. Like 800 Dashar. The one which Cunninger Valdus ran away from. Coward! Whoops, did not mean to do that. Ah, it doesn't matter. Do you have any tasks? You want me to escort you to Jarek's home? I can do that. Let's go. It's not far. I think they do get... What, where are you going? Windholm? You told me it was Jarek's home. Okay, so you just outright lied to me. I'm pretty sure that said Windholm. Who are you? Ethos Merchant Caravan. We'll run to Key on the way. Probably a bit risky as that group was already faster than we were, but no, we still have them in sight. You're literally going to the furthest one away. You said it was to Javik's home. Okay. To Windholm. Did I just read that wrong? And now we're out of food. Fan-freaking-tastic. Yeah. You're the guys that were going to attack us? You are. We'll go and fight you. How many of them are there? They have 60? Huh. Simply because we do have some reinforcements on the way. There's only 4 men. Screw that. Yeah. Everyone's pissed off with me now. Oh, man. Yeah, that's right. Who are you? Good on Doomseeker. Make them run away. Right, Ruvar, do you have any food before we have to feed people again? You know, it's almost lunchtime. Group volunteers and buy suppliers. We'll just get some fruit. That'll do for now. Oh, man. So, they made it. Huzzah. Anyone here I want to hire? Nope. Marketplace, we can sell this stuff. And that, I guess. We still want marketplace though, in order to buy some more food supplies. That'll do. Okay, so do we need to go and speak to them again? We do. So we need to make sure we go back to Coulomb. But we can do that on the way back up north. Do I really care about Yule? Not really. Or do Ruvar? Well, these are just so far away from like the usual recruiting grounds, which are up here, so I'm not going to bother. We'll start in Odasan, then basically try and raise relations with all these ones. And that'll be kind of our recruitment circuit, because they're far closer together than all the way down there, in the middle of Nowheresville. Bunch of upgrades. 2 and 1. All of you. Both of you. All of you. Recruit villagers, speak to the elder. Anything I can help you with? How much grain do you need? You need 4 grain. I think I can handle that. Recruit some more. We'll run off to Valombre and see if we can find 4 grain there. There is a feast in Highcliff. Okay. Ooh, and a tournament. Sweet, we'll join that. Bacchus Noble, don't care. Julia, don't care. Marketplace. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll grab 5 because they do actually eat it as food. Again, I pressed the wrong button. Go away. Actually, I do want to show you this one. Because this was one of our original scenes that we made. We don't have that many in Pendor, but this is one of them. We did get a world designer, who was a Poover. He was one of the main people behind Pendor 4, so I'm hoping that we'll be able to introduce some more of his stuff in a later patch, probably 3.8, including, as Knight von Winter was asking, the Beacon of Hope. We are probably going to implement that into 3.8, hopefully. It might be in a slightly modified format, but it will still be the scene. Because we need a way of having Pendor speaking to the Amala troops, particularly if we want to introduce the Ashenborn, and I'll talk about that in a minute. And that would be one way of doing it. So this is a really, really cool scene. This is actually one of his first. He was kind of disappointed with it, because you can see how flat it is. It doesn't look very, like, interesting, but for a first effort, I'd say it was pretty, pretty freaking good, to be fair. And they only get better from here. And actually, Abhuva and I went into business after we stopped working on Pendor. We did release a game. It didn't do particularly well. However, we are working on a upgrade from that. Well, I should tell you the full story about that, actually. Next time we are legitimately running around somewhere, I will. It's kind of funny. Alright, let's join this tournament. This is all infantry. This suits us. There is one archer. As long as we keep strafing, this should be fine. 2-on-1. We have Jocelyn. Sweet. Well done. Jocelyn got both the kills, though, naturally. Give me a two-hander. Oh, man. 4-on-1. Definitely going to be playing a team here. Now we're going to take their archers out. Oh, poor red team. 3 archers. That's harsh. Okay. Now this is going to be more difficult because there's so many of them. However, they have been fighting and we barely have. So hopefully they are wounded. And there we are. Victory. And I believe that tournaments are a good way of getting prestige and honour. Ow. Right, so the Dawn is so fast and they're good with shields, which we are not. Still got a bit of the cold there, but most of it's gone. You're an archer. Why are you running over that way? Okay, slightly weird. I think it's actually easier to do this, just blocking without a shield. You actually block more quickly. Shields are only really effective against like multiple enemies and archers. Oh, it's 2 against 1, basically, because they have an archer. Suits me just fine. And that guy went down so quickly. Ow. Nice move. So I'm moving back here. Stay as far away from the archer as possible. Oh man, axes block so slowly! Ow. Phew! I was legitimately worried there. Oh, this guy shoots quickly. Just perma-stagger him back. It's the way to beat archers. Well, it's one way. This is the final. Wow. Okay. That, yes! Ha ha! Bring it. Just see the difference there. Give a man a two-hander. Game over. So we made money. And we got a Dishara armor. Interesting. I've not heard of that before. So we will take a look at what that is. Oops, that's the wrong button. 5414. I think that is better than what I currently have. Cool. And I can do this. No, not that. How do I do it? I'm sure there's a way. It's not just putting it into the discard pile. I thought there was a way of putting it in, like, the central pile and then they can equip it. Where was that quest? It was in Odasan. Ooh, wow. Three armies. Heretics, Jatu, and Eldoran all appeared on the same tick. Wow, that is really kind of unlucky. So we have completed that. We'll recruit another bunch, and we'll speak to you, see if you have anything else that I can help you with. Nope. Okey-dokey. So yeah, this business I was in, it was a company called Zotobo. It still exists, kind of. We released a game about 4 years ago, I want to say, about the Vikings. I was writing a novel at the time about Vinland, so the Vikings going to the Americas. And it didn't do particularly well. We released it on Desura, but couldn't get onto Steam. We did get on Steam Greenlight, but nothing through that. So about 2 years passed. We were basically on the verge of wrapping up the company. I'd actually done all the paperwork for that. You want cattle. Okay, hate cattle. So we'd done all the paperwork to wrap the company up, and it was basically, we were done with it. Game over. And then about 2 weeks after we'd done the paperwork... What? Where'd you come from? It's only 18, but still. So, yeah, we did the paperwork. And then 2 weeks later, we got an email from Steam saying, oh, by the way, you have now successfully been greenlit. We want to publish your game. So, of course, we do a very, very quick about-face. And have been working on a new kind of enhanced edition version since then. And that game is being published by the other company I work for, which is Gwythdarion, which is the one I'm doing with a Saxon Dragon. So for this fight, definitely my biggest asset is going to be my crossbow, so we need to keep them safe. The enemy looks to be all cavalry. Oh man, we're going to suffer a lot of casualties here. We just need to keep kind of moving the infantry around to engage. We'll put the archers up here so they have the height. Infantry, move there, please. Uh-oh, here they come. Oh, are these the Meletine nobles? Oh, they are. So these are basically Meletine nobles from the Meletine Empire who have joined the snake cult. That was a good start. Okay, you're dead. Doing 22 against 13. Jeez. Ow, bugger. I wish I'd hit that. Okay. Well, they're in amongst my elites now. Looks like our infantry took an absolute beating, but the archers are actually mostly alive. So this is excellent. This is precisely what I was hoping would happen. I do have a lot of lances though. Let's see if we get you. Stupid shields. Infantry, come back, please. Don't hit Fred! That was surprisingly dramatic. This armor is a lot lighter than what I was using before. Those horses have, like, no hit points. Or else I just hit very, very hard now. Yeah, 124 damage. Nice. Who's left? Oh, one foot guy. Really?
Everyone, take them down!
That was kind of a lucky escape, to be honest. Hello. Yeah, the fallen Militine nobles. So that's showing like the corruption spreading in Amala. Things are not going well over there. Oh, we got another heretic writing. Sweet. So definitely keep those books. Wait, heretic writings? That's wrong. That should be snake cult. That's something I need to report. A bunch of throwing spears. Fair enough. So yeah, we are now working on this enhanced edition of the Vinland game, which I'm really quite... Quite excited about. Hopefully I'll be able to say a bit more about that in the future when we have some more to show. But it's really kind of surprising the power that Steam has just to completely turn you around like that. I don't think any other publisher would have had quite that impact. Like, we're about ready to call it a day, wrapping stuff up, and then we get that email and just like, okay, back in business. Let's go to Ambershorn. Hang on, we did have a quest, didn't we? We did that one. 8 heads of cattle to Rizzi. See if Ambershorn has any cattle. These places I don't think have been looted, so they should. Whoops. Speak to the village elder. It's the only way to get cattle. And I wanted 8, so 5 and 3. Do you have any tasks? You don't. That's unfortunate. Okay. So talk to the cattle. Drive them onwards. Like I said before, this is definitely one of my favourite tweaks. The cattle follow you instead of having to chase them around everywhere. There we go, Rizzi is done. So we'll speak to the village elder. Sup, dude? Whoa! You apparently didn't like that I killed your Militine guys. Or are you brigands? You might be brigands. Hi. Outlaws. Okay, you're not snake cults. Thought they were snake cults because that guy was in green. Hi. Bye. 300... Two-handed weapon skill. Marvellous. Not quite order level, but I'm definitely high tier now. And I leveled up. Which is funny, because I only just did... Oh wait, that was Fred, that wasn't me. I meant to give him charisma. Whoops. Right, I'm doing agility, because I want more athletics. Don't want tracking. Could do with inventory management, to be fair. Yeah, let's take that. I did make Fred wrong stats. That's irritating. Though he was already on 22. So there's only one more point until he's 24, then I can make both of those 8s. I think that's all the strength, yeah. And then work on the charisma again. Nah, it's not all bad. Okay, onwards. Actually, I should speak to Mr. Rizzi. Because we didn't actually do that. I've got you that. Anything else I can do? Nope. How about giving me some more troops, though? That would be lovely. Onwards. Let's go to Key, or Kay, or Quay, or however you want to pronounce it. More troops ready for upgrades, including Leslie. Good. Let's do that. We'll put Leslie and Sara should be at the bottom. And make them militia, we upgrade you in intelligence. You will have points in first aid and engineer, probably. Though first aid's kind of pointless. We'll do it all in engineer, though I'm sure first aid will catch up. And I did actually reduce the army battle size to 600, down from 800, so hopefully it will run, like, solid. Which does mean that things like first aid are slightly more important. You don't need anything. Whoops. Getting impatient with the clicking. Click, click, click. Okay, so I'm answered about the Beacon of Hope, which segued into the story about Vinland. Sorry, it was a bit broken up. Obviously, my attention was a little bit unfocused because of that fight. So I hope it was understandable. If you do have any questions about, well, don't tell that, that stuff, then please do let me know. I'll be quite happy to answer. I did get a very scary letter in the mail, actually. Like, snail mail. I never get snail mail. It was addressed from California. It was from a legal department. So I was getting a bit scared because we were just starting this Sotobo stuff up again. And then we get this, and I was thinking, oh, great. Someone's obviously after us for copyright infringement or something. I mean, that's the kind of thing you usually have to battle with as a developer. And it was actually a notice of bankruptcy. I was thinking, well, I know we kind of closed the company down, but we didn't do it officially because we didn't send the papers off. So were you after money? No, I had to recheck it. It was Tuzatobo, and it was another company I'd never heard of, Bad Juju Games. What on earth are they? I have no relation to Bad Juju. Why are you sending me this stuff? And it turns out that because we released our game through Dezura, Dezura itself actually went bankrupt, or the company behind Dezura did. Can we take that? No. I thought I'd like to. No. That's like a Heretic Vanskeri group. That's funny. So yeah, this Dezura had gone bankrupt, and because they still owed us like $10 from sales of Vinland, technically we're a creditor. I'm not going to chase them for it or anything, but it made me amused. And the reason that I don't think we can actually get anything out of them is because we have a contract saying you have to have sold a certain number of games in order to collect money. I think it's like you have to have $500 or something in profit before you can collect. We only made 10, so not worth it. Does no one want any help around here? Kind of ridiculous. You after me again? Yes, but you're quite a lot slower. There's 58 of us now. As soon as we get the... No, we have the training. Yeah, maybe I can do this. Worth a try, I think. Let's do it. These guys healed up, more or less. Yeah, let's do it. They'll be in two waves. They'll have the cavalry from the Heretics, plus the Vanskeri warriors. And then after that, we'll have the wave of ordinary Vanskeri troops. Archers! And what's left of the Heretics, which shouldn't be too bad. Do we even have any cavalry anymore? Have all the Barclay guys died? Let me through. Get out the way. Right, so we are in position. They are not charging us because they are Vanskeris. And they do tend to try and get a bit organized. They're over there in the distance. So we've spotted this little hill. It's not a very big hill, but it's my hill. This is my hill. There are many like it, but this one's mine. Cavalry! Just looking to see if any shields light up. Doesn't look like it, so no. We've lost the last of the Barclay Lancers. Okay. Is that cavalry charging us? No, they're just getting a little impatient. Let's put you there and you there. Yeah, this Tashara army must be lighter because I feel so quick right now. It's definitely noticeable when you have less weight. So one of the things the developers are doing for 3.8 is going through all the items and rebalancing. And the guy who's doing it keeps on trying to make stuff heavier. I'm like, no, think of the infantry. Don't make stuff heavier, please. Like, he wants to make crossbows 3 or 4 times heavier than they currently are. I was like, but only infantry use them. No. I can't see the banner. I guess it's about there. Stick our archers up on the hill. Infantry can go a little in front of the hill. Apparently we've caused some of them to dismount. Can't say I'm sorry. Put you guys there. You guys there. So we seem to have missile superiority right now. It's just that these guys aren't particularly accurate. Being Feardsvane archers. Low-level Feardsvane archers. Oh, Sapper got someone. Is this going to annoy them? It did. Excellent. Stand by for their charge. And then kill. You're withdrawing. It's fine by me. Is that them dead? Good stuff. Well done. So their cavalry did a little probe, failed, and now it's back to the ranged combat. In fact, did they just send in the heretics? Kind of looks that way, doesn't it? They sent in the heretics and they suicide run. They all died and then the Vanskeries pulled back. That's hilarious. That's kind of like Mettenheim having Barclay troops. Send in the Barclay guys. Do what they do. Except we do have a bunch, like, the core of our army right now is Barclay, so I shouldn't be mocking them. Hold your fire. I want you to have your shields out, please. Those of you with them. Alright, off you go. Just gonna try and draw some fire away. Mission accomplished. Hi. You should always watch your back, people. Excellent. Good victory. We lost 11, they lost 30. We get a halberdier, though. I'll take him. Armsman? Nah, too expensive. Right, we're going to access the pool, we're going to throw the breastplate in there, and then we're going to let them select. Someone will probably have taken it. Really? No one? So Roland's just getting even more corrupt. He's taken the demon shield. Oh, he gave up the helmet, though. Sir Jocelyn's now the secret snake cultist. That's great. Breastplate. There we go. Dieve took it. And we can sell this stuff. Not that there was very much. Right, good. Onwards. Cullum, that's where we did this. Yes, it is. So we need to hand that in that quest. We'll recruit some volunteers. We'll speak to them. We'll complete the quest. Good. Some of your famous bread. Why, thank you. I won't say no. Any more tasks? Nope. Recruit volunteers. Another 5 guys. Thank you. Much obliged. Then we'll go to Javik's home and we'll sell their stuff and then we'll continue this little loop up here. Ooh, some more sappers. Yeah, go on then. Now the other thing I was going to... Oh, we could do this. Yeah. The other thing I was going to talk about, of course, was the Ashenborn Empire. Very amusing responses there, actually. I hadn't really expected it, but having read them, it makes total sense. Like, the number of people who think it's, like, Mettenheim mixed up with, like, the Empire... Kind of makes sense. I mean, thinking about it, Ashenborn, you know, it kind of sounds volcano-y. So it's plausible, but unfortunately it's wrong. It has nothing to do with Mettenheim. There are a couple of you, because I know I have spoken about it before, I can kind of remember what I was saying, but it is the remnants of the Bacchus Empire. So these yellow guys down here, this was basically an invading army which attacked Pendor several years ago. I can't remember the exact timeline, I'm afraid. It might even be as long as like 50 to 100 years ago. They conquered this much of the land, and then they kind of stayed. Meanwhile, while they were attacking, Amalet itself, which is down here somewhere, was conquered, or was attacked by the snake cult, and they lost. So these guys kind of split off, forming what I call the new empire, but has kind of been reinstated as the Bacchus Empire. And Amala fell to the snake cult, so completely fell. But then there was kind of a resistance movement which has sprung up, and that is what we know as the Ashenborn Empire. Started in the northern highlands of the snake cult territories, because highlands are much harder to hold. And yeah, that is the Ashenborn, and I'm hoping that you'll be able to see some of them in 3.8. Hoping. I mean, this, I'm being very careful. I don't want to promise stuff here. We do only have one programmer. So there is a limit to precisely how much we can get done. But these are assets that we have, and I'd very much like to see implemented, because they were done on Pendor 4. 15 recruits, cool. So where is this daughter of yours? Gustav Legatus, you're an empire. Oh, and I need to go and hunt you before I forget about that. Whoops. Yeah, definitely need to kill you. Come back. I know it's slow, but come back. Okay, so this is between me and them. So everyone else, just stand up there and hold your fire. That means you, Lethalaran. I know you don't like listening to orders, but in this case you're going to have to. I thought I told you to dismount, though. Ah, I had to do that first. For some reason, if you keep the formations on, then they don't like dismounting. Don't know why. Bug. So while I'm just running, another question asked by Knight von Winter as well. Aren't the Noldor from Tolkien? Yes, they are. It's just Norse for elf or something. Likewise, there's Sindari. They're also Sindari in Pendor. They're like more powerful elves. But I think that Tolkien had the Noldor as the highly magical ones and the Sindari as non-magical. We have the reverse. And I admit, calling them Noldor is not something I'm particularly happy about, but that's entirely Saxon Dragon's domain, so I'll leave that to him. I would have liked something a little more unique. But the Noldor are like one of the oldest things in Pendor, so we kind of have to keep them. Similar to like the Knights of the Lion and Sarleon, those are all original content. Things like Mettenheim, Barclay, and like the foreign factions are more new, so they're more nuanced kind of as a result. I know Saxon Dragon means to write a novel about it, so he has to keep that kind of stuff for that. Spare you. Very well, I will spare you. Whoa. That went down in price very quickly. 450 to 35. Okay, so Dude Bro was the next thing I needed to do. Gustav Legatus, do I know where you are? Near Janos, but that's 10 days ago. We'll head down there. We've done our thing with most of the towns over here. In fact, this episode's getting a bit long, so I'm going to speed my way down to Janos, and then I will probably end once I've spoken to him. Oh, who are you? Singalians. You're probably quicker than I am. Oh, you've given up already. Good. Sure, caravan. Tempting. But no. All of you become militia. You become one of them, two of them. Armored Axemen. Very nearly got Huskarls, finally. Our army is definitely improving, slowly but surely. Whoops. How's food supply? Food supply is fine. We're passing so many juicy targets, but I'm in a hurry. otherwise I would normally do it. Welcome. More heretic armies. Man, there's a lot of armies in this world. Not a bad thing, it means that a lot of stuff's going to happen. But, yeah. Armies. Aha, and here we make money. So we got 1,900 and we have to pay out 2,000 in wages. That is roughly equal. I'm totally okay with that. And our tannery in Janos is actually making a profit now. Whoa, traffic storm. Oh, that's where we provide the dyes, isn't it? Yeah, it must be. So, yeah, don't build a dye works in Janos. Build a tannery instead. Thank you for those tips, those of you who said them. Let's go with 5 and 10. Whoa, who are you? 59 Empire Crossbow Deserters. No. I need a higher level. But they might catch us anyway. Unless we stay near Marius. Are you going to fight them? Okay, we'll fight as well. Oh, I really can't do this right now. I'm going to say don't get involved. I'm going to save right here. And we'll do that next time. So, a little bit of suspense. Are we going to be able to beat the Deserters? Probably. Join me next time to find out. If you've enjoyed this, please do like and subscribe to this channel. I'll try and keep the little tidbits going. I'm quite happy to talk about like my own business opportunities and how I got into it. That's something I should probably talk about, how I actually got into the games industry. Although you probably can kind of guess that story. If you have any tips or comments, please do leave a comment. Tips or advice, please do leave a comment. That's it. Man, my mind is kind of wandering. It's good not to be ill, or so ill. I'll see you next time. Goodbye.